Hello everyone, this is GoFish Gaming, and welcome to the Anthem Open Demo. So, I skipped the first few missions because quite a few people already, you know, recorded those. So, yeah, we're just gonna start on Mission 3, Convergence.
Sumner's position. Do you see it?
Yes. Going after him.
Have you found Sumner yet?
He left the fort. I'm trying to get to him.
Hurry. Baddie's lost the ability to perceive time and space normally.
What?
It's complicated.
I'll go as fast as I can.
Looks like he's stopped. You should be able to catch up.
Like half of my moves. Thank you.
to attack.
Do you think they ambushed Sumner?
Wouldn't rule it out.
He must be in the area, but he might be hurt or worse. We need to find him, quickly. Sumner's not in the crashed suit. He must have taken it off for some reason.
Hello? Freelancer, is that you?
Sumner? Matthias?
Yes, it's me. Bloody scars, I knew I couldn't take them and there was a crack in the rock.
And you couldn't fit into it while wearing a javelin.
Wait, I think this passage leads me to the ruin I was looking for. I'll keep going.
Stay where you are.
I can handle myself and I'm already here. There'll be another entrance. Meet me inside.
Underground somewhere. How's Maddie?
None of his major organs have liquefied yet.
Major organs? What about the non-major organs?
Just bring back the manifold and Sumner as soon as you can.
Some kind of cabin oracle.
I guess there's only one way to find out.
I'm sensing some strange energy. What's down there?
I don't know. Sumner has the manifold with him, and he came here for a reason.
This place is exactly what I need.
Okay, it's kind of...
to a different rune would provide us with additional insight. Different rune, different energies. He was right, but we knew we needed a javelin to get out of here, and neither of them had the guts to borrow one.
You mean steal?
Sure, whatever. Something unexpected about this place. I have to silence it, but I need time.
A Titan? No, more than one Titan. Three Titans. Wait, three. This glitching manifold is doing it again.
Leave it to me and fix that relic.
Let's just try and fix our settings real quick. So I'll check the controls. And even though the keys in the corner of my screen say like Q, well, say like slash and H, apparently they're mapped to like E and X, which is weird. And I don't quite understand why that happened.
Teeth are tinkling. Air tastes like purple.
The reality decay is getting worse. He's fragmenting. How can I help?
It's all right. I made peace with it.
This isn't just about you. It's the end of all of us if we don't do something.
There's nothing to do. We don't have the answer.
Maybe it was always supposed to end this way. Because just let it be.
Let it be. Yes, that's it.
You genius. Get the manifold.
The Freelancer removed it from its original housing.
After it affected the Dominion soldiers, and when we divide it...
You severed the connection again, out of fear.
Courage.
Hold on, where are you going with this?
Manifold needs more time.
It needs to go through its full cycle.
We're gonna have to let the manifold complete what it started.
Let reality settle. But if it settles, that means our division...
could... become permanent.
That's so bad.
Certainly won't be dull. What do you say? Yet for a new adventure? Always.
Okay. Flip the switch.
Right.
Finished its cycle.
That's good, right?
A rush. What a rush! I think it worked.
No chance of liquefying.
Time will tell.
But now we have enough to help Alec with your Dawn Shield.
Really?
Yeah, especially with the data Sumner found.
Does this mean that Matthias will never be whole again?
Who says we aren't whole?
Because, you know, dressing right?
Because
it was courage.
I assume you meant fearless.
Oh. So that's all the story missions. Neat. This game actually turned out to be a lot more fun than I expected. And I think next episode we're gonna try the Stronghold, just to see what that's like. So, see you guys then. Hello everyone, this is Gopher Brush Studios, and I was just exploring a free play area in Anthem, and I found this place. It looks fucking sick. Let's do a little bit of dungeon crawling, shall we? We went all this way and someone's already been here. Because I just picked up an item. Fuck. Someone else is here. Somewhere. Or was very recently and then left. This looks sick, though. This game has some seriously cool exploration areas. Oh shit, free blues. Let's go. Okay. This place is neat. Too bad I probably missed, like, the boss or something. Aw, shucks, that teleported us directly out of there. Let's just go through it, like, quick. Or is this gonna teleport me back to the bottom of it? Okay, maybe this time we'll actually encounter some of the enemies. Yeah, this place looks cool. I feel like Anthem as a game is sort of like, I don't know, like a weird hybrid between, like, I would say Destiny 1 and like, Warframe in terms of, like, its... In terms of, like, its crafting system and its world exploration, world building without any dialogue kind of stuff. But then it's kind of like Destiny 2 in, like, the abilities of its javelins, but... Oh yeah, I don't know why this happens, but it's so annoying, the like weird camera jiggle. I don't know what causes it, but it is so annoying when it happens, and you just sort of have to wait until it fixes itself. But yeah, this is like the second free play area that's sort of away from everything else in the demo. It's a lot bigger than the first replay area, because that area is, like, sort of you, and that's about it, at least from what I could tell. This area, there's a lot more to do. Let's get ourselves some minerals. This place looks amazing. I don't know. I just sort of like areas in games where it looks sort of dilapidated. I don't know why, but I just do. Oops, didn't mean to do that. One thing I don't like is if, at least this javelin's ability, it doesn't necessarily have, like, a lock-on of any sort. I feel like it, like, not like an extreme lock-on, but, like, just some sort of lock-on would be helpful. Or, like, I don't know. So, because a lot of the times when you're using it, you just end up attacking walls. But that may just be because I'm used to games with aim assist on, like, their big attacks. Also, this sniper rifle is sort of weird. But I like it. It's super fun. Get kills with it. It's sort of weird in its aiming system. Instead of it being, it's like a charge shot, which is sort of weird. Like, I would get, like, hold scope to get better shot, but it's hold. To get your stronger shot, you hold your actual fire, and you can't do, like, a weak hook shot, which is kind of weird. One thing that's really annoying is if you happen to die and you don't have anyone with you, it's like a whole process to get back to where you were, so gotta try and not die as much as possible. Which is difficult when there are enemies who have sniper rifles and then burns. So now we have to go, like, all the way back here. From, like, the start of the map. Or just this, I guess. Oh. It's not, like, literally any other area where it, like, fucks everything up if you die once. guess we'll try and get back to where we were. I think we're not anywhere near it. But we'll just sort of see what happens. Wait, are we on the opposite side of where we were? Yeah, we are. Okay, that's kind of weird. I think if they make anything with self-heal, a lot of people are gonna main it. Just cause, like, that'd be really overpowered. The way the game is currently balanced. Especially with these burns. Ugh, getting a burn is so annoying in this game. Especially if you don't have shield. Just screws up the entire flow of combat. Just, it's okay to have something like that, it's just burns happen way too fucking often. That's why I don't like dealing with any enemy with a flame attack. Oh, I just lost my shield. What the heck? And now I have a burn, so I'm guaranteed to die. Okay. Yeah, that's like the way to kill immediately is just if someone gets a burn while you have no shield, you're basically just screwed. Which is sort of annoying. Wait, is... Whatever. But yeah, it's kind of impossible to deal with that kind of stuff. Oh, the server just shut down. Okay. Well, I guess that does it for this episode, since I'm not gonna restart that section. So I guess see you guys next time I choose to record. Bye. Welcome back to looking at cool shit in Anthem. Look at this place. This is amazing. Like, holy crap. Oh, this game is so pretty. Also, off screen I had like two disconnects. But then again, it is kind of early in the morning when I'm recording this, so I wouldn't expect the servers to be at peak performance. Oh, what the heck? Whoa, this whole place is actually a proper area?
Scorpius, you need to clear the nest.
Holy crap. I did not expect that. I thought there was going to be like an area edge. I like these little areas because they're like fun to screw around in. I like just the fact that in this game, instead of it just being like, oh, there's like a million markers that are telling you where to go in the free play areas, like it is with like Destiny and Warframe, where it's like, oh, there's a thing like a mile away, you should go do it. And this, it's just like, oh. You sort of fly around, see where you can and can't go, and then occasionally some cool shit will happen. It's awesome. The free play areas in this game are basically just what if every open world shooter game was actually fun. Still haven't figured out what those red things are. Like, I know there's the blue ones that you can walk into. Is there a way to, like, automatically detonate those? I freaking love this game. It's so much fun.
Got it! That's done. We need to clear this lot before we do anything else. They're too much of a threat.
This game is so fun.
Look at that! They're running! Down one scorpion nest, that's what I like to see.
Woohoo. Now let's claim that chest. Oops. Kept pressing E. One of each gear type. Cool. Let's see if there's anything else here. Just because I kind of want to see the boundaries of this map. Okay. That's a boundary. I still haven't... Oh, you just press escape. That would make sense. Wait, did I end up in the other free play area? I think I traveled from one free play spot to the other. Yeah, this is the other spot. I remember this spot. There is actually stuff here. Transition into like a later time in the world day was pretty smooth. Like, that was amazing. I don't know what I was doing, but there was one mission I got like 15 coins out of like one world event. It was so cool. I don't remember what the event was, but it was freaking cool to see that happen. Oh! That's why I wasn't dealing damage. They have, like, shielded parts. That's pretty cool. Yeah, this... I feel like this is the first open world area that actually, you know, feels open. Cool. Too bad you can't boost while you swim. Like, that'd be awesome. Whoa. You just came out of a waterfall. That is sick. That is actually really cool.
Detecting a big wave of shaper energy somewhere close at hand.
Ooh. Another event. Usually I find like one and then at some point I end up... Oh, it's one of these.
You've got an angry Ursix to deal with. Be careful. Scum. Very bad things.
Oh. Oh Oh, that just took away all my health. Okay, the grenade literally fell on him. Why didn't he explode? This game is like a mix of a bunch of games that I found like incredibly fun. Like it's like a mix of Warframe, Destiny, and I think a little bit of Dauntless actually. At least that's what this fight's reminding me of, is like a Dauntless battle. It's just like a huge beast that can do a shit ton of damage. Okay, you got three. Ah, the movement in this game is so fluid. Like every move makes. Hey, welcome to more and of the event I was doing. This is so freaking cool. Just saying. Oh god. Oh shoot, we are running low on health. We almost got him down. Oh, we got a new guy here. There he is. Damn, we got all the fragments. Got him! Holy crap. That was epic. That was a cool fight. I keep pressing E instead of F. Didn't get that much out of it, but... Alright, never mind, we did. That was so fun. Yeah, I really like this game actually. Like it's a pretty good time waster, I would say. Like I've been playing the demo for about 4 hours now, roughly. And I hardly even noticed that much time came by. But it is so fun. Like holy crap. Like this is I didn't think that all these elements could be mixed together and work, but they totally did. it mixes together so many interesting, unique game design types. Like, and it works. I think there might be a dungeon nearby. Yeah, it's a cave, probably. Where is the cave? No, it's just a little hole. It's like the big scary monsters area. Let's see if there's more this way. I just keep finding more stuff. I'm gonna say this is probably a map edge, yep. Or not? Oh wait, yeah, it is. There. Yeah, this place is freaking cool. And there's such a decent weapon variety. Like, I feel like the only weapon type this game's really missing is swords. Those, like, swords and bows, those would be heckin' sick. Like, if they added those, oh, this game would become, like, my all-time favorite game. Probably. Like, it's just got so much stuff to do. The fact that I've been occupied by it for so long and not noticed, like, a lack of stuff. It's pretty amazing. This game is so freaking cool. Oh, it didn't activate a single one of the grenades. Are you kidding me? That's fine. Just keep exploring. There's just so much to do. I don't even know if I've doubled back. I know I've double backed on myself at least once, but besides that, like, the areas are so varied that sometimes it's hard to tell when you're doubling on somewhere you've already been. There's a bunch of these little dungeons too, which is sick. Like, all this. This area was used in one of the story missions, but it's a cool area. It's nice you can visit it outside of it. Is that like bismuth or something? Looked like it. I think this place is just like a beast den. Like, just a bunch of animals. Yeah, I think the marksman rifles are probably... Marksman rifle and assault rifle, I think, is my favorite combination, though, in this game. Just because they both can work well at close range. So if you do run out of ammo of one of them, you can still use the other one. Or like the other combinations, it's usually like super close, medium, or super far away in medium range. There's never... I think this is the best working combination. Look at this game, it's so freaking pretty. Like, anywhere in this game is wallpaper material. Got some outlaws here. Game is so fun. The movement in this game is amazing. Like, if anyone likes, like, movement-based shooters, this is the kind of game for you. Like, from what I've seen of of gigantic. It kind of is familiar, like this game design, at least for Anthem. Then again, I haven't seen a lot of gigantic. But like, if you find gigantic cool for its movement stuff, this is like the PvE equivalent of that, I would think. And I know there are PvE segments, but like, just yeah, this game is freaking cool. It's just got so many opportunities to set up like awesome combos. Like, even if you're not using like a loadout that's designed to work together, like you're supposed to use the glaives, like all your melee stuff, and then you use the grenades and stuff for something completely different. But everything is so fluid in how it functions that you can really just do whatever. So it kind of reminds me of Paladins in that way, I would say. Like, how you can change your abilities like crazy, but it still feels like you're playing the same thing. Because in Paladins, you like can use certain cards and buffs to like completely change how you play. This is sort of similar in that respect, I guess. It's really good at giving players a chance to like get away from stuff, which is good because there's a lot of stuff that can just completely wreck your shit, but most of the time, except when burns are involved, this game is very fair in how it deals damage. And I complain about burns, but if I just used my abilities right, like, I literally could make them non-existent. Welcome back to some random exploration and stuff, because this game is full of cool shit. Basically, the series has went from my first time experiencing this game to me fucking gushing over how good it is. Like, I haven't even done all of the stuff they, like, specifically tell you to do. Like, the like, fort or whatever thing. It's highlighted in, like, purple on the map. I haven't done that yet. Mainly because I'm just like, I may as well reach max level. It's only 15. Yeah, the free play areas like are super fun. Yeah, like look, I can just use this ability and bam, burns don't exist. I just forget I have it a lot. Yeah, there's so many just opportunities. It's wild. You can do a lot of crazy stuff in this game. It's amazing. Sorcerer dudes are like the hardest guys to actually kill. Oh shoot. There's someone here who's downed? so I'm just gonna get back to what I was doing, which is just clearing this place out. I mean, I don't know if it's possible to clear it out. Probably isn't. It's freaking cool. Plus, chance to get good loot, so. May as well try, right? These grenades are so specific about how they set off that I still haven't exactly figured it out. Oh god. What was that? The guy's behind me, most likely. Oh wait, have there been mines on the floor the whole time? Yeah, this game is so freaking cool. Oh, it was a shotgunner. That's why I was getting destroyed. Because they're like the counter to everything I do. Because if I get too close, then I'm screwed. I also love that, like, you feel powerful. Holy crap. I don't know what that is. But I assume he's the boss of this area. I'm just gonna... Where did they even land? Nowhere. Sort of pick off all of his minions quick. Fill up my super bar before I get to them. And also because they have a chance to drop health. Okay, where is he? Get rid of those guys. Where's this next dude? Oh, that's the guy I was trying to get. Holy crap. He soaked up so many attacks. Oh, that's why. Because he was either... Because he was a legendary enemy. Huh. It's cool. There's like multiple people. I love that these enemy tiers like exist. Because in a lot of games there's like two. Well, there's three tiers. There's like boss, mini boss, and then normal enemy. For this one, there's normal enemy, mini boss, stronger mini boss, even stronger mini boss, boss, and then I think there might be like stronger bosses after that too. There's so much to see and fight in this game. It's great. Crap, it's a sorcery dude. Okay, that was weird. My attack stopped working for a second there. It's so satisfying. Getting your abilities to... Oh, he got his shield back. That's not good. That is the opposite of good. Gosh, he keeps bombarding me with his stuff. I really don't want to die right now. Oh gosh, no shield. No thanks. There's more guys here. I didn't even know. That's not good. I guess I can kill them for health. Oh, they're everywhere. That is even worse. Ooh, I think there might be some legendaries in here. Just saw some yellow markers on my some yellow indicators. That's concerning. I like how this game, I don't know, it's got its quirks so that, like, I don't know, as you find stuff and learn about it, it doesn't feel like it's forced learning. Like, it feels like you're actually learning what to do in a natural way. Like, yeah, I'm all for tutorials in games, because a lot of games, it's like, what the fuck am I doing? But in this one, it's just everything's so intuitive that you don't need a tutorial. Like, yeah, my screen's a little shit, so I had to look up buttons. Well, what my button inputs were, but once I figured it out, it made sense. And really, it really just depends on the quality of what you're playing on. Like, I'm sure the game's a lot better if you're playing on a better computer with better monitors, but it still, like, feels fair. Like, I feel like I'm being rewarded for trying to do everything on my own instead of looking up tutorials. Because there is a tutorial section, but you don't have to use it. It's optional. Also, I'm pretty sure the tutorial section's a lot more complex than most tutorial sections, where it's just like, here's how to do basic movement. I think it's actually, like, one of the good tutorial sections, where it, like, talks more about complex stuff you can do. Oh, I can't believe I forgot that healed me. Okay, welcome back to Anthem, where we are continuing to just explore and have fun. So that's what this game's all about, I feel. Just finding what about it is fun to you, and then you can just do that. Like, yeah, I could do the missions, but you don't have to. You don't have to do the missions to get good stuff. You can just do whatever. 15 Masterwork Ember. Huh. I wonder what those do. Just got 5 coins. Neat. I also like that, like, the cosmetic currency you can just sort of get. I don't know what the drop chances are for it, but I've been getting it pretty decently. I also like how the coin currency, which probably in the actual version of the game you can still get from drops, but you probably will be able to buy it from the store, I imagine. I like how you can get it from wherever. You can just get it doing things. Any game where the premium currency doesn't have to be premium is awesome. The guy keeps disappearing. It's rather annoying. Really, the only major bug I've noticed is sometimes when you're in the open world segments, you'll go to fight a group of enemies, and then once you get to them, they, like, disappear. But, I mean, that's just the nature of it being an open-world game. There's gonna be bugs, like, despawning. It just happens in these kinds of games. I honestly, most of my problems with this game, I can totally, like, see why they're there. And sometimes something that's a problem at the start becomes, like, a really cool feature when you actually use it. Things regenerate their health, because if they do, that's real annoying. The worst part about them is they do so much damage. The amount of just sheer and utter DPS you can do is so exhilarating. After having games where, like, DPS doesn't fucking exist, it's like just the amount of damage you can do. And not feel like. Shield. Let's fix that. I love that casting ultimates gives you health back, because there's a lot of games where you cast it and then you don't get your health back, so it's completely wasted. I also love how, like, efficient the ults are in this. Like, they last long if you, like, don't use them, but, like, if you're using, like, if you use them sort of passively, like, you're in a tight spot, then, yeah. Or, like, use it to clear out, like, a bunch of enemies who are sort of few and far between. It doesn't, like, run out by the time you get to the second enemy. It sort of keeps going. But then when you're dealing with, like, a tight pack of enemies, you can kill the enemies in the pack, but then you don't necessarily have your ability lasting long, which is cool. I like it when games have their ultimates balanced so that so much to do in this game. Like, you could spend a whole day on this and still, you'd spend like a week just like non-stop playing and you probably still wouldn't find all the cool stuff, because there's just so much of it. So much to do that in reality, compared to other games, there isn't a lot of space. But compared to other open worlds, yeah, the world isn't as open, but it feels like there's more here, if that makes sense. Oh, that's just my idea. And we're back. I feel like the only real problem I have with it is the respawn system. I don't know. I just don't like that it puts you so far away. Like, I guess the good thing about it, though... Did he explode when I shot his rocket launcher? If so, that's like... That's really freaking cool. That they would do something like that. in this game. That's a really cool feature. Not a lot of games have is like. Single hit. Oh, he's okay. Let's just get away from him. Just focus back on this. There's a bunch of gold stuff. I also like that every action in this game, like everything that you do, has like a reaction from the enemies that makes sense. Whoa, that dude looks cool. Holy crap, I want his cloak. But I don't want to play Storm. Storm is not my class. Like, yeah, magic casters are cool and all, but I don't want to play. I'm just, well, one, this is already my second javelin, and I'm pretty sure you only get two in the demo. Unless maybe you get one. Maybe you get another one at level 15, I don't know. I don't know the level progression, because I'm not going to look that kind of stuff up. Distracts from the flow of gameplay. I don't know, there's just something about this game. It's a very charming game. It's a very sort of, you go into it not expecting like, you're just expecting it to be like your standard open world shooter, aka empty, and then you start like actually exploring, and it's like, wow, there's tons of stuff to do here. So I don't know, like every time an ability, not every time, but most of the time that you screw up, like most of the time when you screw up an ability cast, it feels like you are actually the reason it screwed up, and not because the game wanted to for no reason. Because there's a lot of games where ability casting just sucks. But in this one, like, your ability casting makes sense. Like, every ability cast feels like you're totally in control of it. Shoot, okay. Got that health. But yeah, the movement in this game. I know I've gushed about it a lot over the course of these few episodes, but it deserves to be gushed about. It is amazing movement. Oof. Oh. These guys are back here. That's not good. Okay, that works too. Oh, shoot. That is a very powerful character. I would assume he's got a gold health bar. He's there for like a second though. Oh yeah, that's one of those guys. It's one of the super tankers. His shield lasts for days. Holy crap. Got him, though. One problem with... Well, it's not really a problem. The only real, like, super big learning curve, besides learning the controls for everything, like... The only learning curve after you learn how to use your javelin is is in the free play segments, learning when to leave. That is a problem I've had, because I stayed too long in the free play, and just sort of come back and I have way too much stuff. Or I stay too long and I start getting wrecked by other things because I'm not upgrading my gear. Because you can't upgrade your gear until you get back to base. He just regenerated his shield when I was at the last bar, didn't he? What a jerk. I think maybe the red spots are the, like, fast travel areas. Not for getting to some things, because you can't fast travel into them, but you can fast travel out of them. Because usually there's some sort of platform somewhere with interact on it, and then you leave. Guess we have to go out the old-fashioned way. Once you get those guys knocked down, they're not too difficult to fight. It's just getting them to that point is a pain. Okay, let's just collect these materials. Then I think we're gonna end this mission. Okay, let's see what we got. Holy crap. A ton of expedition feats. Pilot level increased, minor component slot. Cool. See, we got cluster mine at level 14. What, power 14? Power 14 relentless, power 16 target beam, power 18 shield enforcement. Reinforcement. That's pretty good. Level 14 cluster mine. Let's just salvage that, because I think this is a better cluster mine, right? Yeah, let's get rid of those old cluster mines. Wraith strike. Ooh. Interceptor projects a ghost of itself that can warp up to three. That's cool. Level 16 resolution, 18 armor enforcement, 16 devastator, 16 blast back. Guess we'll just get rid of one of those because we have two. Tempest strike and low level shield enforcement. Okay. It's a pretty pretty good mission. Okay, now that we finished that mission, let's get... I love that you can just sort of view what the actual javelin looks like when you're not inside of it. It's cool. Now we are going to level up our stuff. Okay, so this is the loadout stuff, so let's just see what we got. So level 18 cluster mine, we'll get rid of that level 15 one then. Oh, it's equipped a different set, so I can't. Let's go to our weapons. Power 17 anvil. Okay, the rest of these are just power 16. So you can... Can I get a better warden? No, I didn't. Warden's a assault rifle. Nope. Okay, so don't have anything to replace that yet. I guess we can do some clearing of stuff. Just anything under... Level 15. That isn't already clipped to someone else. Let's get rid of it. Yeah, anything under 15. We're just gonna get rid of, because 16 is our max right now. Okay, components. So now we can attach, so shield or armor. Increases javelin armor by a large amount. Increases javelin shields. Okay, what's this one? Do I have a better heat sink? No, I don't. Let's just get rid of all these. Welcome back to customization, where we're just figuring out what the heck we're gonna equip. Right now we're just getting rid of all of our normal stuff. What's this do? Describe a component that augments javelin ultimate gear. So we want heatsink, because that increases our capacity, which allows us to fly better and longer. Let's see. Increase our melee, or we could increase our shields and armor. Well, I think our shields are fine, it's just our armor is low, so we'll equip that. And sadly, we won't be able to get our next slot, so that sucks. Okay, then our strike system. So right now we have Plasma Star. So let's see. Because that's good, because it's ranged. Any of this really ranged? Powerful close range melee strikes. There's actually ghosts that can warp up to 3 targets. I think we're just gonna stick with Plasma Star because I don't really want to screw with those. And I think we're just gonna stick with Rally Cry as well because that's just useful for getting rid of stuff. What would be a good wear state? This dirty old. Ooh, I kind of like that. Yeah. Standard, clean, new. Yeah, I like old. That looks cool. Plus, it sort of hides the line from my vinyl a little bit better. Nah, we're not gonna screw with our other loadouts. Yeah, this game has so much fun stuff to do. Like, you can sort of just go all over the place. I actually think, yeah, it is one big map. I guess we'll start at the closer area now. But yeah, there's just a ton of stuff to do in this game. I highly recommend it. Ooh, there's a chest behind us. Let's get that. Yeah, the flight in this game, it takes a little getting used to, but that must be the Dominion Patrol. Once you got it, it's fun. Okay. Bring a stop to a patrol. So apparently these guys are like our antithesis. Like, we use Shaper Relics, they can stop them. I think that's it. I'm not entirely certain. Whoa! What the hell is that thing? We broke away from that. Perfect time. We have no shield. See if we can lead them into the mines. Assuming that's enough. Oh gosh, we have no health. Fights in this game are real satisfying.
There's a gate. Just be ready.
Oh no. That concerns me. Oh, it's one of those. That means there's gonna be a ton of them. Run away from that. Oh, I actually killed one of them? Holy crap. Wow, okay, I accidentally fucked up that last recording. So, now we're doing... I screwed around with customization a bit. event. Stop ducking away.
One of their best is headed your way.
Oh, that's not good. These guys are really fast. Oh gosh, the camera shaking starting. Someone tripped the mans. Got him. This is tense.
You have just taken out one of the Dominion's best.
Holy crap.
Can't leave things like this, you've got to secure the area.
Ooh, gosh, we are low on health. Well, that's annoying. The enemy is now outside of the mission boundary. Camera shaking again. Got it. Did it.
One less Dominion patrol to worry about.
Amazing. That was awesome. Okay, so that area is outside of mission boundaries. You know that. Have I been here yet? I think it was. In a later one, in an earlier part. Yeah, I definitely was here. Okay, we're gonna go this way, because this is the way to the dungeon. If I remember correctly. Which I should, because it was just a few hours ago, but... Yeah, I think that's the dungeon up there. Oh, is it? Oh, I think I was picking up their dying log entries, maybe? Oh, prevent. Let's go. Oh, person here. Oh no, it's one of those guys. Oh shoot, he just exploded in my face.
That's it. Don't back down. Keep up the pressure. We're turning this around. We need to stop it.
Watch my back!
I think the shield enemies are really the only ones I don't like. Just because not only do they have a shield, but they also have flamethrowers. So two of the most annoying things in a game when you're playing the frat. Welcome to the... It's gonna be the last video of the demo, probably. Or at least this recording session. We got a bunch of stuff. What the heck? That looks cool. I don't know exactly what's that, well, what that is, but it looks freaking sick. Yeah, this is like the dead end area, isn't it? I wonder. I fly fast enough. Yep. Knew it. Or not. Guess I was wrong. Either that's not an area you're supposed to, well, that you, that's an area that we'll never be able to go to, or that's like right in between. It's like an area where you can go, an area where you can go, and then right in between's the death barrier, and I just got stuck in the middle. Or it's an area that, I don't know. It'll be used in the actual full release, but not the demo. Because there is like a ton of the map that's blacked out. Unless maybe it's because I didn't explore it yet. No, I've been out to all those places. Oh, cool. It actually shows, like, the entrances and exits of all the places you've been to. I mean, granted, it's not like you can mark them on the map, but I actually, I don't know. In some games, I'd like to be able to mark locations, but I think this game's an exception. I actually prefer to not have it marked. Oh, what the heck? Random freelancer. Is there gonna be an event here or something? Doesn't look like it. Okay. Either there's going... Oh wait, no, I think that's the freelancer we just helped. And they just stay around for a bit after the event's completed. This would be weird if they just disappeared. Okay, welcome back. I left for like a second there, so something might have changed. I guess we will just sort of fly around and see if we find anything. Might be something up here. Oh, this is the double cross area. Gosh, it's a big boy. Oh gosh, the screen shaking's starting up again. Oh gosh, this is one of the massive faces. Oh, event.
Yes.
Silence the Rock. What? Okay, this is interesting. Whoa. Oh, it's this area. Is this still part of the event? Or did the event just allow me to explore a normal area? Okay, hey, this part of the event. Oh god, it's a Titan. Oof.
A Titan. That's a Titan! Well, good luck.
Thanks, dude. I'm gonna need it. Oh, it's a... Oh, right, because Titans are literally the worst possible. Holy crap, I did it. Did we just get 4 coins? Just got 10 coins. Amazing. Is there something else? It's gotta be, right? There's always something else. It? I think that was it. Must have been. It's rather anticlimactic. Oh. It's rather anticlimactic. Hope I can get another one of those monster fight ones. Well, it's not really a monster fight event. That's only part of the event, and it stays there after the event's over. And we're back. I guess that was it. It's cool though. There is something to do in the... Oh god, what the heck? Oh right, the demon birds. Let's just run from those. Yes, this game is amazing. I think that about does it for this episode. Anthem. Tune in next time I decide to record content. Probably not from Anthem though, because I'm just gonna work on enjoying the game by myself.